Drew Tube. Welcome to Hashtag Religion Week TV. I'm your host, Drew L. Murray, and here we sip a lot of tea with no shade, talking everything up the Yahweh. Enjoy the video. Tea, no shade.
Blind ears like Christ did. If I could lay hands on you and open up your blind eyes from birth, I pray for it too. But I know he spoke words, he spoke life, he spoke truth into people, and those who believed him received it, and their eyes were opened up and their ears were opened up, okay? So it goes on here to say, all right, so we know proud look, lying tongue, hands that shed blood, heart that devised wicked imaginations, feet that be swift to mischief, false witness, speaking lies. See, he had to say lying tongue and false witness speaking lies. There's two different kinds. One just lie all the time. Others go out there lying against people. Hold on, YouTube. Almost done. So I'm going to try another device here later on. Okay, so we got the bare false witness. And he had to say that twice. Lying tongue and bearing false witness. Speaking false witness against somebody with lies. Because that does more damage on a person than a person just lying out their mouth. But when you go bearing false witness and lies against other people, then you're hurting other people's credibility. You're standing in the way of other people's money, other people's way of life, other people's way of growing in this world. Hell, you might be the next community leader. You may be the next Oprah. You may be the next Tyler Perry. But because people are coming at you wrong, coming at you indifferent, coming at you ungodly, it'll steer people away from them. That's why I'm going to be true to myself, true to the word of God, true to God's word. See, some of y'all Christians out there talking about be true to thy own self. That's Shakespeare's word. Be true to the word of God and you'll see change in your life. I can't be true to nothing else but what he's showing me. And if I don't know it, how can I be true to it? But once he show it to me and I don't make that change, that's when I become disobedient to God. That's when you become disobedient to God. Is that clear? So I said we was going through chapter 16 through 22. Let me read on 20, 21, and 22, and we'll be done, okay? Hang on, YouTube. So we're almost done. I have on there verse 16 to 22. So verse 20 says, my son, keep thy father's commandment and forsake not the law of thy mother. Okay? But I'm quite sure back in this time, the mothers was trying to instill this into their children. These are the things God hates. Don't do these things. And what do we children do? We went away straying, a whoring, a fornicating, being led by other gods, being this kind of people, being these prideful, hateful, evil, wicked people that you see today on Facebook, in your churches, in your family, in life, period. They not hearkening to their mother, but the Bible says in the commandments, honor your mother and your father and your days will go long with you. I may not be your mother, don't want to be your spiritual mother, because God says you only have one father in heaven, but you Christians out there calling everybody spirit father this, spirit father that, spirit that. You don't know. You're not listening to the word of God. But there's somebody who is. Whether I do it all right or not, I hear what thus said the Lord is saying. And as he's speaking to me and I change my life, it's okay to speak it to you to see you change your life. I'd be wrong to sit on this and not share it with you. Because the Bible says, he who know to do good and don't do it is a sin. Is you doing good? Is you doing good? But it also says here, it says, my son, keep thy father's commandment and forsake not the law of thy mother. They was drilling this in on their people. YouTube almost done. I'm gonna get me 3 good 30-minute videos out of this today. Yes. I'm absolutely gonna get some good footage today. Anyway, hang in there, honey. We almost done. Alright, Salafa. So verse 21 says, bind them continually upon thy heart and tie them about thy neck. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? I'm going to share this with you briefly. I was in trouble when I was 19 and I got sent away to prison, but they had a program called SHOP. I was able to go to that SHOP program to reduce my sentence. In this SHOP program, it teaches you a lot of things about self-discipline, character, how to change. It's not all godly, but it's enough tools to help you be a different person. And one of the ways they used to try to train people not to curse is if you did curse, they'll put this thing around your neck, say cursor or whatever word it is you kind of said, and you have to wear this thing bound around your neck to show that you probably said a curse word or whatever. And this just reminds me here, bind them continually upon thy neck. See, when I was 19, prior to, hold on YouTube, I don't want this to get away. I don't want this to get away, to get away, to get away. Thank you, Salafa. So what I'm saying is, and this is my truth, prior to 19, I had a lot of things bound on my neck that probably was not godly. God put me in a position where I got arrested. I went to prison, jail. I met 2 wonderful ladies, Pat and Marianne. They came into the jailhouse. We reintroduced myself to Jesus. I went to prison. After that, I don't have those things bound on my neck anymore. I'm not prisoner. I don't have any yoke. The only yoke I have on my neck is the yoke of Christ. He says, he that is heavy laden and burdened, come unto me, I'll give you rest. My yoke is easy. My burden is light. That's the only yoke I want. I don't want the slave master's yoke. I don't want Christianity's yoke. I don't want the pastor's yoke. I don't want a lying, cheating husband, disrespectful boyfriend yoke. I don't want badass kids yokes. I don't want a jealous co-worker yoke. We don't have those yokes on me no more, okay? You do change with the word of God. Some of y'all is still yoked up, unevenly yoked with the world and with a lot of other stuff if you fit this description right here in verse 16 and 20. Excuse me, verse 16 and 19 is the descriptive content. Verse 20 says, listen to your mother and your father. Hold on, YouTube. Almost done. Almost done. Almost done. Almost done. Thank you, Salafa. Almost done. So verse 20 says, listen to your mother and your father. Bind this on your neck, 21 says. And 22 says, when thou goest, it shall lead thee. When thou sleepest, it shall keep thee. And when thou walkest, it shall talk with thee. I'm a talker and I love this. When I got hold of this scripture, bind this truth on your neck. Let the yoke of Christ be on your neck. This is speak. It says, when thou goest, it will lead thee. These commandments right here. When you sleep, it will keep thee. And when you, it says right here, verse 22, it says, and when thou awakest, it will talk with thee. That's the kind of life I'm trying to live right now. That's the kind of experience I want going on in me right now. I don't want to wake up. I don't want nothing bound on me that got me gossiping about you, got me lying on you, got me hating on you, got me deceiving you. I don't want that kind of stuff bound on me, and you should not either. I don't have that stuff bound on me. As you notice, I don't talk about y'all. I don't click with y'all. I don't do none of that with y'all. Why? Because the word says differently. Hang on, YouTube. This is the last thing I'm going to say. All right. So, 23. We got to get to 23, and then we wrapping it up. I didn't go down to 23 when I was reading this morning. But it says, for the commandment is a lamp, and the law is light, and reproofs of instruction are the way of life. Who don't like reproof of instruction? Who don't like to be corrected? Who don't like to be shown the errors of their ways so they can be a better person? That's what God does. That's what the Word of God does. And what happens is, for years, you may not have been taught the Word of God. We may have been taught differently. Now, God comes along and shows somebody else the truth and show us, wait, this is how we're supposed to be living and doing it as a Christian. And you're so caught up in doctrine with what you think and believe that it's hard for somebody else to come along a little joyous with it, a little more at peace with it, a little bit more, even though the Bible says envy, strife, and love, nonetheless, Christ is being preached. But because somebody come with a little different swag on the Word of God, how he gives it to them with my personality, because I'm not pretending to be none of y'all out there, because y'all the fake ones. Y'all the ones running around here calling yourself Christians and don't even know what the damn word means. Oh, let's just go there. We don't have to, because we talking about things God hates. He don't hate fake Christians. He love y'all. He just know that you being fake right now. Hold on, we gonna wrap this up. One last time. I'm gonna get this out. So if Facebook go out again, I can say bye to Facebook. And come on, Facebook. Come on, Facebook. Yes, Facebook is back in. So basically, 23 says, for the commandment is a lamp. See, you were taught in Christianity to do away with the commandments of the law, right? Of Yahweh. Even Christ told you to keep his commandments and to keep his law. But you let the Roman Grecian church come in after Christ resurrected and went back to the Father and tell you differently. But God is saying, okay, listen, I talk about commandments and laws a lot in my word. And I would not have given you commandments and laws if they wasn't to be kept. So, right here, Proverbs 23. And Solomon was the wisest man who got all wisdom from the Lord. So why would he put this here if it's not true? This, I believe with my spirit, is true. For the commandment is a lamp, and the law is light, and reproofs of instructions are the way of life. Reproofs of instruction. See, you think you've been taught right in Christianity, and when someone comes, the Bible says the word of God is the all sound doctrine for teaching, correction, reproof, instructions. It's back here in the Old Testament, in the New Testament somewhere. Usually I could go right to it, but like I said, I'm not in study Bible mode. I'm just in talk mode right now. But it says it's for reproof, correction, to be rebuking. A lot of you Christians don't like or want to be rebuked or reproved or corrected. You think posting Jesus loves you is going to get you to heaven, honey. That's why you have so many battle scars on you and in your life, and so many defeats. Hold on, YouTube. Hold on one second. I just want to keep them. Thank you, Salafa. And that's why so many people as Christians live in defeat right now. Yes, we hoop and holler and say, yes, Lord loves me. I go to church and spit a Bible verse out there. But every day you also come behind that Bible verse and you complain about a sickness. You complain about a broken heart. You complain about all of this stuff. that God don't want you to go through as a Christian. And if somebody comes along and tell you, wait, maybe you've been looking at it wrong, maybe you've been listening to it wrong, maybe the people who's been teaching you wrong, been taught wrong, and you want to crucify me. If I didn't love you, if I didn't care about you, I'd let you burn rot in hell. But God didn't create me to be that person. That spirit doesn't walk in me, and I will fight till I take my last breath. Make sure you get the truth. God says, feed my sheep, and that's all I want to do. Whether you digest it and shit off of it, I could care less. I'm just trying to feed you. Now, you digest it and you crap and dung, shit, whatever you call it, because that's what it is. That's on you. That's on you. All I got to do is feed you. And if you don't allow me to feed you, somebody else will allow me to feed you. I know I'm not out here trying to feed nobody in vain. Last topic. Hold on 1 second. So thank you, Salafa. So God says, it's not what goes into a man that makes us unclean or defiles us. It's what comes out of our heart. He says, feed my sheep. See, a lot of people, let me just go back. Everything you're putting into your body may not be a defilement unto God. But you've been taught it has. Tell them to tell you this. Christ says it's what comes out of the man's heart, what comes out of the heart of the man, because out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks, is what defiles a man. God says, feed my sheep. That's all. If you don't eat, someone else will partake of this good nourishment. I only have to make sure I feed the sheep. It's up to you to digest it, and it's up to you to crap it out. One way or the other. Or you could be constipated on it and stay full with it. I don't know. But I don't worry about that part. And neither should no other witness for Christ. He told the disciples, you leave your coat, your cloak, your money, everything home. You go into these territories, take nothing with you. If they receive you, you do well. You lay down in their beds, their houses, you break bread with them. If they reject you, you turn around. Hold on, YouTube. Hold on, YouTube. Hold on 1 second. Oh, shoot. I almost sound like Candy. Every man need a woman. Shout out to Kaya Love. Hi, Kaya Lynn. Every man need a woman. No, I'm just joking. I'm sitting here playing with YouTube Salafa. There's a joke going around about Candy Burris. She had gotten this real deep voice when she was singing with her escape tour. We're not that holy. We don't hear about other things that's going on in the world. And if you let things you hear go on in the world consume you and get you to be worldly, then what kind of Christian are you? I heard that one of the roasters was saying she had a deep voice and was like, every man need a woman. And I felt my voice getting deep, so I took the moment to break that little, to put that little joke in there. But anyway, here's the thing. Christ Jesus, we cannot allow these people to condemn you, crucify you. They're going to persecute you. That's, if it's really God that you're pursuing, you're going to get persecuted. The Bible says, consider yourself blessed when that happens. Blessed is he who's persecuted for righteousness' sake. So you're going to be persecuted, okay? But to just have somebody lying on you, false witnessing you, having a proud look about you, or saying you proud in some kind of way, saying you shed an innocent blood, saying you the one with the divisive, wicked heart, Hold on. Hold on, YouTube, hold on. Hold on, YouTube. Okay. Hey, Patrick, how you doing? So, yeah, so when they got that proud, when people saying you the one with the proud, the lion tongue, the proud look, the hands that shed innocent blood, heart that devised wicked imaginations, feet that be swift and run into mischief, false witness that speaketh lies, and he that soweth discord among the brethren, these are the six things God hates, seven that's an abomination to him. And all I'm saying is, people, look at us. Do you fit one or all seven? I don't want God to hate me. That's why you don't see me out here doing this stuff right here, partaking in it, okay? Because the church have made you believe that it's your drinking, your smoking, your loud noise, your unfornicating sex. That's all in the Bible, but that doesn't say in reference to, some places does say God, the will of God is not to fornicate, but I'm telling you what God hates. This is the kind of people God hates. And we run around here talking about God loves us. God loves, ooh, love, he loves me. A lot of us he don't love. And it tells you right here in the book of Proverbs, chapter 6, 16 through 19, it tells you what God hates. But then if you read 20 through 23, it tells you how you can remedy that. It tells you how you can remedy that. So with that being said, let me just say something. Hold on, YouTube. Yeah, I'm trying out purple lipstick today. I have on a little purple tank top here, purple and white. So anyway, thank you all, Facebook. So what I'm basically saying here is that verse 21 through 23, it has a little remedy for it. We all know repentance. We all know we've been taught wrong. Some of us is just so proud, once we learn something, we refuse to say the person who taught us was wrong, or we refuse to admit that we've been learning wrong. We refuse to admit that, man, maybe this is the truth right here. Maybe this is makes more sense than what we've been practicing all these years in Christianity. Again, I'm not against God. I'm not against Jesus. I'm not against the Holy Spirit. I'm against who took the Bible and kind of manipulated it. If you read it, the New Testament itself is really like a slave master's book to control people who he gave the Bible to read. And said it's God's word, it's your religion, and this is what you must do. And we've been doing it and doing it and doing it. And God keeps saying, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves. One of the ways you humble yourself is to say, oh, Christianity, maybe I've been taught wrong. Maybe I've been doing something wrong. Maybe that wasn't God. Maybe Christ didn't call himself a Christian when he was in the face of the earth. But people who wanted to mock him. Remember the Bible says, be not deceived, for God shall not be mocked. Who's going around mocking God? Somebody maybe who got you calling Christ Jesus. Yes, you too. I'm just waiting for Facebook to come on in here. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Hold on. We got to wrap it up. Okay, because we over the hour mark now. I think hour and a half or something. We got to wrap this up, guys. Listen, Salafa and Patrick, if you're ever talking with me again, and please type, it was something I was going to say when I was talking about the deep voice and candy birds. If I'm talking and the screen go out, and you could always say, yo, but you were talking about this before the screen went out. Just to refresh my memory, I told you I'd be led here. I got a lot of good stuff to say. It's a lot of word in me. I love talking about the word of God. I love showing people not where they're wrong or the errors of their ways. God does enough of that for us, but God is saying, okay, somebody out there is not believing or thinking straight, haven't been taught properly, And even so, a lot of our pastors and preachers and teachers don't take the time to study like this and to open up your eyes. They just make you feel good in church to get you to give money and be down with their nonsense and deception than really giving you the truth. So again, I'm only trying to feed God's sheep, whether you digest it and crap off of it or stay constipated. That's up to you. I enjoy talking with you guys. I'm not, like I said, I'm not sarcastic or anything like that. But I used to be passive in my Christianity and what God was saying and using through me. And hold on one second. Hold on. Hold on, YouTube. One last time. Okay, sorry about that. So yeah, I used to be passive as a believer, as a Christ-like person in the world. And I think that's totally, sometimes passive can come off as being weak. And we're not weak people. I'm not a weak person. The Bible isn't weak. Christ wasn't weak. God isn't weak. Meekness is strength under control. You'll see a lot of that out of me. A lot of people say a lot of things to me on my page, off my page, in person. And I'm very meek. I don't feed into the negativity, the drama. You'll never engage me in that because I do have some of the word in me. And the word tells me to come from amongst them. It says, blessed is he who sits not in the council of the ungodly, stand in the seats of the scornful, or sit in the congregations of the wicked in Psalms 1, 1 and 3. So I'm trying to put this to my life. So you'll never catch me out here doing what most Christians and believers say and do. I'm my own person. I love my personality. I have that and some, but sometimes you get caught up with, you have to have on a suit and tie to speak the word of God, or you have to have on some red bottoms and all this to prove that God has blessed you. And I'm trying to tell you, I'm loved by God, because if you had to look at Proverbs 6 and 16 and 19, I'm not the one he hates. Hold on, YouTube, almost there. Hold on. Thank you, Salafa and Patrick. And if you had to go by Proverbs 6, 16 through 19 and judge a person, then you will say to yourself, I'm not one of the people God hates. I'm actually one of the people God loves. I'm actually one of the people who have not a spirit of fear, but power, love, and sound mind. And I'm one of the people who the commandment is a lamp for and the law is a light. Now, I know you know in the book of Psalms it says the word of God is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my pathways. Well, it kind of goes with Proverbs 23, because the word is the commandments of God, is God's commandment. The word Jesus is a commandment of God. So if you, Jesus Christ, he said the two greatest commandments I give you, and all the other commandments hang on the prophets, love the Father with all your heart, mind, and soul, and love your neighbor as you love yourself. And Christians, you fall short because you can't even love another Christian. And God says, if you can't love your brother, how can you say you love me? That's why he put in his Bible why he hates these things. Is it making sense to you now? And you run around here talking about you love Jesus and you love this and you love that. But you the one God is. God says, I'm just going to end with this. Hold on, YouTube. They went off. Hold on, YouTube. Hold on. Last. Thank you so much. This is it, guys. We run around here talking about God loves me. But you got to look around and see if there's any people like the ones you see in the book of Proverbs And it's not our job. Oh, you doing this, you doing that. Oh, because you got a proud look, because you got a lion tongue. God says he hates seven things. Do you fit this description? Are you falling into any of these categories? Are you the one with the proud look? Are you the one with the lion tongue? Are you the one with the hands that shed blood? Are you the one with a heart that devises wicked imaginations? Are you the one with feet that swift to run to mischief? Are you the one with a false witness and lying tongue on somebody else? Are you the one sowing discord amongst the brethren? That's what you gotta ask yourself. Those are the people that's destroying your community. Those are the people that's destroying your homes. Those are the people that's destroying your schools. Those are the people that's destroying your government. Those are the people that are destroying your churches. But you allow it to go on because you won't say nothing. And with that being said, you too, I am done with you. God bless you. Thank you so. Thank you so much. I almost lost that. I will do more videos for you. We will get personal and intimate. Like I said, I'm confident in the things that God is talking to me about and having me share with you guys. And I just want you to get confident and know that we can admit when we're wrong. I can. Everything I probably don't say is right, but I know if I take you to the Bible, it'll be close enough to be like, oh, she wasn't quoting it verbatim, but it's here. And I do study enough where I can say by verse, chapter this, verse that. But when you're talking to people, that's more study. That's God says study to show yourself approved, so you need not a workman. Show yourself approved unto God. 2 Timothy 2:15. Study to show yourself approved unto God, that you need not be a workman out here ashamed. Meaning you ain't out here working in the word, working trying to get souls saved, and being ashamed about it because you don't know what you're talking about, or because God didn't give you this word. No, he says study. That's what he didn't say. Drew study, Salafa study, Patrick study. He says study. Study to show you that anybody could do that. But instead, we run the church. We take what pastor say from his mouth, being word, and his word ain't no more word than the word of God. Don't trust nobody over God's word. You trust God first. And that's it, you know? And you study to show yourself approved. Rightly dividing the word of truth, so you're not a workman out here ashamed of nobody questioning you about your relationship with Yahweh. And with that being said, you too, God bless you. Have a great day. Keep talking it up to Yahweh, man, because that's the only one that matter. Keep talking everything up to Yahweh. Talk everything up to God. It doesn't matter what we talking about. I can talk to you about sex, but it will include God. It will show you where the Bible talks about this, that, and that. We could talk about abuse. We could talk about anger. We could talk about whatever it is. Put it in the chat box. We could talk about it, because as long as it exhorts you, it comforts you, and it encourages you, that's what real prophecy, that's what a real prophet does. A prophet doesn't talk you up to tear you down, or to want to know your business to put it all out on Facebook. Everything is done up to Yahweh, up to God. Why? Because it's God who sent us and sends us with this message. I don't call myself a prophet. I don't put nothing. But the Bible says desire to prophesy, and that's what I do. And prophecy talks about in the book, in the Bible, exhorting, encouraging, and comforting people. And that's what I do. I use my YouTube channel. I did have Twitter, but I lost my account over there. And I use my Facebook page to exhort, encourage, and comfort, because that's what real prophets do. And if there's going to be destruction, let me just say this, YouTube, and then we all could go. Hold on one second. Let me just say this real quick. All right, come on, Facebook. Okay, so let me just say this to Lawfer and Patrick, and then we could go ahead and have a good evening, a good day for today, for now. But, and a real prophet of God, if there is destruction in the land, in the tribe, home, house, whatever, if God knows there's going to be destruction, he will send a prophet with a warning. That's how you know true prophets. It's a lot of fake prophets out here. You see them falling too. I don't have to call any names. Just go online and put in false prophet. And put in exposed prophet. Put in what you want to put in. Everybody's name going to come up. And you do the research and look at their life. And see how they went from, oh, I'm a prophet of God, to now walking in shame because that prophecy wasn't a true calling from Yahweh. And they're struggling now to try to get followings and people to still believe in their credibility with God. Everybody is meant to be forgiven, but not everybody. The Bible says many are called, but few are chosen. I'm not out here saying, I'm just talking what God has showed me. God, I talk to God. Why is people like this? Why is people hateful? Why is people mean? Why is people badgering people? And God will take me to the word and show me, because this is what I love to do. This is what I love to do. So YouTube, you have a great day. God bless you. Thank you for the fellowship. Again, talk everything up to Yahweh, because he has all the answers. Thank you. And remember, read Proverbs 6, chapter 6. You can read the whole chapter, but read Proverbs 6, 16 through 19, okay?